Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from my viewer. MOV is faster than fuse to detect spikes. Why MOV is behind the fuse? Why cannot we install MOV first and install fuse after MOV? Any reason behind it? Let's discuss. Fuse. When we say fuse, it protects the circuit from short circuits. When we say varistor, any varistor, it is a high voltage arrestor. If we have class X capacitor, it is high frequency detector. This one is over voltage detector and it is connected in parallel line and neutral. And if we see NTC or PTC, it is also a current limiting device. That are protections, and this is surge protection device, but this is current protection. All current protection devices are connected in series, while the voltage protection and frequency protection devices are in parallel line. Now the question, why it is after the fuse, line and neutral are connected in these two lines? It will detect the spike and it will not become short circuit at first spike. Might be it is detecting a number of spikes and it is working. So it will suppress that spikes. It is VDR, voltage dependent resistor, surge protector, surge arrestor, varistor, either it is thyrector, TVS, bidirectional. These all are for voltage protection. This capacitor, it also protects from high frequency spikes. So anytime if its substrate temperature will increase or the strikes are above than its surge limit, so might be it will become short circuit internally. When it will become short circuit, it will blow away the fuse. Sometime it makes short circuit in this way that its two plates are melted together. At that time the fuse will open. Sometimes its plates are separated. At first spark the fuse will burn out and then the plates are separated. Then it will behave like an open circuit. For that example, let's place this resistor here now. If we connect here before fuse, might be it will detect the surge, it will detect high voltage, it will become short circuit. If it was working here, for example, our this fuse is 3 ampere and our power cable is 10 ampere, for example. If there is a short circuit and it will damage this fuse, so the next circuit will be protected. But if we can see here, if the plates are short circuit together, melted together, so it will become permanent short circuit. So the power cable and our line wiring, the wall socket, our main circuit breaker, that will damage. So that can cause to a big disaster. Now see the second condition. At first strike, it damaged and its plates are now open. Now the circuit is directly exposed to any high voltage strike. Why? Because our protection is now finished. Maybe at first strike, at 3 ampere, 4 ampere current, it damaged itself, but the fuse is safe. So that means there is no protection. So the circuit is directly exposed to high voltage spikes. So that can cause damage to everything. So that is the reason that these protections are always placed after the fuse. Either it is current limiting, either it is high frequency EMI filters, class X capacitors, class Y capacitors, either it is unidirectional TVS or bidirectional TVS. So we connect all these protections after the fuse. Why? Because we create intentionally short circuit in case of any abnormal condition. If there are continuously voltage strikes, might be this TVS, it will damage. Might be high voltage strike, it will come here, it will detect. And here is class X capacitor, then there are class Y capacitors. So all these protections are connected here to create our self-made short circuit at any abnormal condition. Any component will become short circuit to protect our next circuit that will damage this fuse. So this fuse must be placed at the entrance. If you have any suggestion, if you have any idea, if you have any comment, if you have any question, please let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.